Now we get to the duty deferral program. So let's see what customs examiners have to say about duty deferral program before we get into jump into the what's going on out there. So duty deferral program. This is the program for more related to manufacturing processes that where something comes into the one NAFTA member of a one member of the NAFTA country, and that member of the NAFTA country transforms the merchandise, manufactures merchandise, or alters the merchandise in some kind of way, and then you go in and you are exporting it, that merchandise, to a different NAFTA member country. And once that merchandise goes into the different NAFTA member country, that's when the duty obligation arises. Not at the time of entry for that for that manufacturing process process purposes, but at the time of entry once that manufacturing is done and that provision that has been exported to a different NAFTA member country. So that's one thing. Duty deferral means it's you delay the duty payment, and you and as we shall see, usually the requirement for the duty payment arises 10 working days after the date of entry. However, in the case of duty deferral program, it is a 60-day rule. So usually we have a 10-day rule. We are accustomed to the 10-day rule, but in the duty deferral program, we have 60-day rule. So it's a new method for the importation. Upon exportation, the goods will be treated as withdrawn for domestic consumption. So we're talking about the rising of the requirement to pay duties. The Customs Administration may waive or reduce them by amount that does not exceed the total customs duties paid to the NAFTA country to which goods were exported. So that means that in addition to giving yourself a break on payment of duties, you also reduce those duties by the lesser of whichever you pay to, let's say, Mexico as opposed to states. In states you pay duties, you have your duty obligation is $10, and in Mexico it's $20 or $5, right? $10 United States, $5 Mexico, right, as translated from pesos. All right, so your duty obligation will be reduced by $5, so you will have to pay $5. So that's another benefit of the duty deferral program. So those are the key pointers of that program, and let's see how this is will be tested on the customs broker exam. So notice timing of duty payment is 60 calendar days. So notice not working days here, which is equivalent to business days. Sometimes they are being referred to as business days, but it's 60 calendar days after the date of exportation or 60 calendar days after the date of entry into duty deferral program. So depending which option you choose over here, this is when your obligation to make a payment kicks in. And of course, as we see, that it's been tested also in a straightforward kind of way. Foreign merchandise that is entered into FTZ and manufactured or changed. And recall, the FTZ is a legitimate purpose of the duty deferral program under Type 8 entry, because we'll talk about foreign trade zones, right, over here. So going back to our question, so it's entered in FTZ for manufacture, changing condition, and then taken to Canada, exported to Canada at a waived or reduced duty amount in the United States. Which of the answers below apply for filing and or duty payment to claim the waived or reduced duty amount under, of course, a duty deferral program here? So here, within 30 calendar days, CBP Form 3461 is an entry form, which you usually file before filing the entry summary. Here, the entry itself would be filed at the time of entry into the United States, but the entry summary form deferred form would be filed later. So A is not correct. The estimated duty must be deposited to CBP 60 calendar days, so we have that calendar day rule, after the date of exportation. So here we have duty deferral, taking it to the previous page, after the date of exportation of the goods, either to Canada or Mexico, right? So B is fits the rule here. CBP form C7501 must be filed with 10 working days after the merchandise is physically removed from the zone. Well, this is not the duty deferral provision, right? It's a regular 10 working day rule. So this one is incorrect. And notice the call of the question is duty payment, not the filing. Here we're talking about the filing, which, if asked, would be under that 10 working day rule. So technically, this is a correct statement of the law, right? Date of expiration, well, physically removed and day of expiration, well, not really, folks. Because physical removal and date of exportation or date of entry into the duty referral program is different. So that would probably kill this. The date of exportation would be, so it can be in transit for several days and then exported. So that's really not on point, so making C incorrect answer choice. CBP Form 751 must be filed no later than 10 calendar days after the date of exportation. So calendar days kills the rule. We don't have calendar day. And E says either D or C are good. And we know they're not good because physical removal kills C and calendar day rule kills D. So we are here not on point. So C, D, E is incorrect. A is not on point, and B fits the answer choice under the 60 calendar day rule for the payment. Not for filing. Filing is 10 working days or business days, but payment itself is 60 day rule.